at work are aptly named. They haven't stopped working since 1979, when they first got together in Melbourne, Australia. And they had to play almost every night for 18 months before they landed a recording contract.
We started off playing in a bar about the size of this room, and we were in one corner of it. We'd have people throwing up all over. It was awful, you know, but very fond memories. I mean, that's where we started. You know, I mean, people would knock over the drum kit and sort of break guitars, and they were just literally that close to you, you know.
Except the cigarette ash down the end of my saxophone, you know, it's really...
You know.
I wouldn't even realise they're doing it, though. I mean, they're just down in this...
Oh, there's an ashtray there.
Their debut album went straight to the top almost everywhere, except the U.S., where it took almost a year for business as usual to catch on.
You know, I went sort of... triple platinum in Canada, did very well in Europe, had sort of broken a lot of records in Australia and New Zealand, done a whole lot of things, you know, before they actually thought that there was something in it, you know. So, yeah, late starters, but better late than never, you know.
To win over America, the men took to the road. They soon discovered that Americans have some pretty strange misconceptions about Australia.
Yeah, sure, they thought we had a king there. You know, hey, you got a king down there? People are still really surprised and that people speak English there and stuff. Well, you speak good English, you know. Thanks very much.
And while they were touring the States, the men had some strange encounters in American restaurants.
I just get confused with all the dressings. I really can't, I'll just have a salad, thanks.
What would you like, that Thousand Island dressing, or French dressing, or Italian dressing? What kind of dressing? You don't want a dressing on your salad?
It's got ringing up people going,
yeah,
weird.
The men's tour of America paid off. Now they're running twice as hard to stay on top. In fact, singer Colin Hay says he's so busy, he doesn't have time to be anything but men at work.
I'd love to be able to dance really well. I think dancing is fantastic. I'd love to be able to learn how to dance, you know, properly. But that's the thing, like, there's no time, you know? You don't have time to dance around.
Likewise, sax player Greg Hamm used to play sports, but now he's sort of lost touch. But don't worry, it's not all work and no play for the men, who occasionally find time for a quick dip. And when he's home, Colin Hay relaxes by watching cricket on television.
If you're feeling really agitated and speedy, you know, just sit down and watch the cricket. It'll really slow you down. But cricket's not big in America, but America can't really sort of grasp the concept of playing a game for 6 days that nobody wins.
Men at work have won big in the United States. Despite all the hard work, you'll never hear them say, it's a mistake.